A lot of people are worried about what's going on in the world right now, and I think with good reason. So what can I offer in this? Why has things come to this? With all the choices we had, how could we end up here in this way? I tell you, because we have lost our connection to God. To God? Yes, our connection to God. What do I mean by that? First and foremost, we have to have a small discussion. What do I mean by God? Because God is a word, a concept that means a lot of different things to different people. When my friends come to me and start this discussion, one of them says, for example, I don't believe in God, Lars. I have to ask them, yeah, okay, but what do you mean by God? You need to tell me, because or else I don't know what it is you don't believe in, you see? And very often it ends up like this person tells me that I don't believe in an old man with a white beard up in the sky. Okay, I said, fair enough. It's a very beautiful archetypical picture anyway, but I understand that. But haven't you done any other thoughts about what God could be all about? Very often, no. But I think the problem in the world today is that we are not connected to God anymore. And that is despite that we were born in the image of God. We can read that in the Old Testament. God created man in his own image. So later on, we can read in Exodus that Moses, he is talking to God in the burning bush. You can remember that. And he asks God, who are you? And God tells him, I am who I am. I am who I am. Yeah, but what should I say to the people? First and foremost, you should go and bring the Israelis out of Egyptians' capture and bring them to the Holy Land. Yes, said Moses, but who should I say had sent me? You go and tell them that I am have sent you. I am. What does that mean? What kind of concept is that? It's not a concept. It's a way of being. You remember in the Gospel of John that Yeshua is saying, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And actually, there's seven of them. He says, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the door. I am the good shepherd. I am the resurrection and the life, and so on. Is it really Yeshua that talks about himself here? No. He's talking about the I am. If we just add this little is to every sentence, it would sound like this. I am is the way, the truth, and the life. I am is the door. I am is the true wine, and so forth. So he's talking about that image within us, that I am within us, in which we were born. Remember in the Gospel of Thomas, Yeshua is saying, cleave the tree and lift the stone, and I am there. There you have it again. I am is everywhere. I am is behind everything. And you know, you remember one of the quantum physics, Max Planck in 1944 said, it is my experience in my work as a physicist that behind everything created, there is an intelligence that is ruling everything. There is a consciousness that we need to be reconnected to, and that consciousness is I am. And we are carrying this within us. Remember, Jesus told us that the kingdom of heaven is within us. So we need to connect to this. Also, you remember that another place Jesus said, before Abraham was, I am, I was, you know? So again, he's talking about that we should not revere humans as such. We should respect each other and have integrity within ourselves and towards others. But it is God, that we need to connect to. And that is exactly what he's talking about. So how do we do that? We need to really find some place of stillness. Be still and know I am. And then we'll start to connect through the breath. Very easy. I am who I am. I am who I am. When we connect in this way, we are able to heal everything through it, but we need to identify totally with it. We need to totally know who I am is and what it is within us. There is healing in I am, and that is why we need to connect to it. And we can connect to it through the breath. That is why I wrote this small book, The God Formula. It is for us to have some tools that is built on the hermetical way. You know, the hermetical way is so much the basics of quantum physics in many ways. The difference is that they have a lot of theories, but they are talking about exact same thing. They're just using other concepts, other words for it. But the members of the old mystery school from the antique world, they didn't just have theories, they had experiences through their own practices. And that makes a whole lot of difference. So I tell you now to do exactly the same. As Jeshua said, follow my example and you'll do even greater wonders than I. And I think we should follow his example and start to see what he actually did. And remember, as he said in the Gospel of John, you are all God's children. He was not the only one. He was the first one, but he was not the only one. Or else he would not tell us that we were all God's children. Yes. So when we start to work with this, and this is urgent, you know, because we need to start today, not tomorrow, because tomorrow might be too late. So really start to feel how this I am within you is identical with the kingdom of heaven that Jeshua is also telling us in the Gospel of Luke is within us and everywhere around us. So when you cleave the tree and lift the stone, I am there. It is a power, a consciousness that is all over, everywhere. Now we need to reconnect to it. And you know, guess what? Religion comes from the Latin religare, which means to reconnect. So let's reconnect now. And it is to do with your consciousness. Just merge your consciousness to God's consciousness by breathing in and out. And make room for this every day in your life, because it's so important, especially now. In reality, there's no separation. But when we are not connected to the I am or to the God consciousness, that's how we perceive everything. That is how we see relations. It's black or it's white. I'm against, I'm for. All these things. And they have no place in the presence. When we are actually merging or manifesting within the presence of God, we are maybe as close as we can ever be to that concept of I am, or to that source that I am is. It's not our concepts about it, it is how we are able to be it and to unfold it, to let this generosity of the I am flow through us and share it with everybody for free. It's about listening to that inner voice of God, to allow it to be present here now, to be still. In Zurich, a couple of weeks ago, we were doing a group healing. There was a young man who had a cancer in the nodes. And we did some I am healing on this man. And after 3 days, it was gone. So this is something you can do too. All of those, most of those who were in that group, in that workshop, had never tried anything like it. But when you connect, when you knock, it'll be opened. Yes? So remember that. When you ask, it will be given to you. But you need to go in there. You need to dare to go into that room, to that space of I am healing. You need to understand who you are and why you came here. You did not come here to demonize others who don't think the same way as you or fight any enemy. There's no enemies. There's only I am children of God. Yeah. So when you look into the eyes of another person, you are looking into the eyes of God, if you will. If you choose to see an enemy, that's what you see. So you decide, you make the choice. But the minute that you connect to the I am, no problem. No problem. I want to show you a picture of my mother. It's taken 2 weeks before she died. And it's the best picture I have of her. Why? Because it's so obvious when you look at it that, you know, the small self has now become I am self. That the ego has more or less been transformed and been merged with the higher self. She's totally crystal clear. There's no more needs. There's nothing to worry about. There's no dramas anymore. Just think about it. All the dramas that we involve ourselves in every day. Stand up to who you really are. Don't hide behind synonymous. Don't hide behind a veil. Have integrity enough to stand up for yourself and be a child of God. Please, the time has come. This is now. You are called now. So that is why we are here. Every one of us has not come here for our own sake. We came here to share our gifts with other people. And we came, fortunately, with different gifts, you know. So I'm come to give mine. You came here to give yours. And this has nothing to do with money. This has nothing to do with charity. Just think about charity. I mean, that we have a word for charity. There should be no word because it should be so natural, a natural part of our whole being, just to share, you know, for free, everything. Of course, everybody has to make a living here. When you do something, for example, it can be flexology, or if you have a shop or you sell a biathlon, you need to have some money in. But you know what I mean. You can give that extra to the I am. Yeah. Have integrity. Be daring. Dare to be who you really are. That's the question. You see, my mother, when you look at that picture, she was so ready to leave this place. And that's another thing that we should all get ready, because our time will come when we have to leave this place. And that's why we need to understand who we really are, because or else we might not get to the place we want to go. Not that I'm talking about hell or anything. But, you know, recognize who you are. And recognize God, you know? Remember Meister Eckhart, the old mystic from the Middle Ages, his famous words that the eyes through which I see God is the eyes through which God sees me. So remember that, think about it. It's very, very wise words. Do you believe in God? They asked Carl Gustav Jung this question many years ago. No, he said. I don't believe in God. I know. Jung knew all about the I Am. And now we need to know about it too. Because it is through this that we can create healing, that we can connect to God, that we can change this world from this darkness that we have surrounded ourselves by, that we can light the fire once more, the fire of healing, the fire of change, the light in the darkness.